We would like to find the solution to the equation x equals the cosine of x. Note the comment at the top starts with a double percent sign. The reason for this will become evident later. Begin by clearing the command window and variables and formatting the new script. We will start by plotting the equation to find the approximate location of the root. The equation must be rearranged such that both x's are on the same side of the equal sign. Horizontal and vertical lines will be added to the graph to visualize the x and y axes. As we can see from the graph, the root is located at an x value of a little less than 1. We will use 1 for our initial guess. The Newton-Raphson method is used by first selecting an initial guess of the root, xi. The value of the equation at this point, f of xi, is then calculated. The slope of the line at f of xi is found by computing the derivative of the function. The slope of the line is extrapolated down to the x-axis to find the new guess of the root, xi plus 1. The error is then calculated by subtracting the two x values. The process is then repeated until f xi equals 0. We will now implement this process using MATLAB code. Type another double percent sign. This separates code between sets of double percent signs into cells, allowing you to run the code in a single cell versus running the entire script. Begin by defining the maximum allowable error and the maximum number of iterations. Next, enter our initial guess of 1 and the starting iteration number 1. We wish to display the number of iterations and results in a table. We will do this using the fprintf command. fprintf outputs strings of text to the command window. Enter the format spec, which is always 1, followed by the desired text in a set of apostrophes. A line of hyphens will serve as the top line of the table. End the text with backslash n to insert the text on its own line. Use fprintf again, this time to enter the header for each column in our table. Because the Newton-Raphson method is an iterative process, we will need to use a for loop. We want the loop to run from the first iteration, k equals 1, to the maximum number we defined earlier. Enter our equation and its derivative, replacing x with our initial guess of xk. Divide the value of the function, fx, by the value of its derivative, fpx, then subtract from xk to find our new guess of x improved. Calculate the percent error between the new and old values of x. Now use fprintf to output the result of the first iteration. Instead of text, we want to format the line to insert number values. Begin the formatting with a percent sign. The number before the period represents the width of spacing in characters. The number after the period represents the precision of the number, and the F stands for fixed point notation. Format each variable we will input as before, but increase the spacing and precision. After the formatting, type the variable names in the order they are to appear in the table. Now we need to implement some logic to tell the loop when to end using if statements. This logic tells the loop to break when the absolute value of the difference becomes less than or equal to the allowable error, or when the number of iterations becomes greater than or equal to the maximum number of iterations. Before the next iteration, we must set our guess, xk, equal to the new value of x, x improved. We must also increase the iteration value by 1. Use fprintf one last time to enter the closing line of our table. To run a single cell, select Run and Advance. Our results are now displayed. The solution of x equals 0.73909 was found in 4 iterations. Now we will double check our answer using a built-in MATLAB function. The solve function solves equations symbolically, so we must enter sims x. The equation can be entered as it appeared originally, cosine of x equals x. A double equal sign must be used to tell MATLAB the equation does not equal zero. After running this cell, we see that the solution provided by solve matches the Newton-Raphson solution when rounded to 5 places. If the original equation is rearranged, it becomes x equals the arc cosine of x, which should have the same solution. Let's see what happens. As expected, the root appears to be at the same x value as before. We will again use x equals 1 as our initial guess. Note the warning message displayed. This could affect our result. Change the equation and the derivative within our for loop. For an initial guess of 1, MATLAB returns the answer of 1. We can see this is incorrect because the y value displayed is negative 1. This happens because at x equals 1, the derivative is equal to infinity. Try a different initial guess closer to the expected value. Now we get the same answer as the solution for x equals the cosine of x. MATLAB still converges on the answer for a poor initial guess, such as 5. Use this solve function to check our answer for the root. Just like before, the answers match when rounded.